Welcome to Movie Shortens. Today, we will explain to you a science fiction action movie called Demolition Man. Spoiler ahead, watch out and take care. The film is set in Los Angeles in 1996. At this time, there is a serious hostage abduction. A helicopter is hovering in the sky. A moment later, Spartan the policeman is assigned to carry out the mission of rescuing the hostages. He quickly swings the rope from the helicopter down and starts to fight with the criminals that are already surrounding him. Spartan breaks the door and swings down to the basement. After dodging a barrage of bullets and defeating many opponents, he runs as fast as he could to rescue the hostages without acknowledging that his every move is now being tracked over the camera by Phoenix. Hurriedly moving down to the room where Phoenix is sitting, Spartan points his gun at Phoenix, threatening him to reveal where he hides the hostages. Phoenix just laughs wickedly. When Spartan is not paying attention, Phoenix throws a cigarette into the gasoline, causing the fire around Spartan. Phoenix laughs out loud as he thinks Spartan is so dead by now. However, right after that, Spartan rushes out of a fire, swooping over and shoving Phoenix onto the table. While the two are fighting, the police has just arrived outside. After a while, Spartan, with the fighting skills of a policeman, has defeated Phoenix. He takes Phoenix out of the building before it explodes. However, the police do not know that Phoenix actually killed all the hostages before lighting the fire. He wants people to misunderstand that Spartan risked the life of all hostages to arrest Phoenix. The angry policeman rushes in and wants to get Phoenix knocked out, but his colleague stops him. After that, Phoenix is sentenced to 70 years in prison and frozen below 0 degrees Celsius. However, Spartan is also found guilty of the manslaughter and receives the same sentence. Time flies to 2032. Phoenix, the former criminal who kidnapped and killed 30 hostages after being frozen for a long time, is about to be on trial again. He suddenly seizes the moment when the police aren't paying attention. He defeats them all. Phoenix pokes the warden's eye so he can open the door and look for the way out. He steals the car and escapes from the prison. While looking for a place to buy pistols, he is tracked by the police. Despite quickly approaching Phoenix's location, the police in this era are used to peace and have almost no skills to round up criminals. The whole police team was defeated easily by Phoenix. The sheriff has no choice but approves the reinstatement of Spartan, the former policeman who used to arrest Phoenix in the past, while Phoenix steals a gun in a museum. Spartan also chases him, and here comes the fierce fight between the two. In one-on-one fight, Phoenix isn't Spartan's opponent, but with a stolen new generation nitrogen gun, he converts defeat into victory and escapes from Spartan's intense pursuit. On the way to escape, Phoenix happens to meet Dr. Cartu, the creator of a new era in 2032. A perfect society without crimes, murders, nor sex. People live on one same lifestyle. When Phoenix tries to shoot Cartu, his finger suddenly goes stiff. Phoenix quickly runs away when Spartan arrives. Cartu expresses gratitude to Spartan for saving his life and invites Spartan to a party. That evening, Spartan and Huxley join the party and sit at the same table with Cartu. Through the conversation, Cactu's bragging makes Spartan feel uncomfortable. Suddenly, friendly criminals, the gang that lives in the city sewers, appears and carry out a food robbery. Spartan rushes out to defeat them without taking much effort, while people keep admiring him for that. After dinner, Phoenix suddenly appears at Cactu's office. It turns out that Phoenix and Cactu had a deal. The reason Phoenix was defrosted is to carry out the mission of destroying Friendly, the leader of the army living in the sewers against Cactu's new society. In return, Phoenix will own all the coastal cities. Back to Spartans, he takes Huxley home. Huxley suggested a crazy sex tonight as she finds a huge admiration towards Spartan. He agrees immediately, but the way people have sex in 2032 is far more different than what he expected. One wears same helmet and sits far away from the other, and then performs imaginary sex. As Spartan finds this new approach isn't very good, he suggests Huxley to do it the traditional way. She gets angry, saying it is illegal, and kicks Spartan out of the room. Returning to his room, Spartan watches a video showing the moment Phoenix escaped from the museum and met Dr. Cactu. They looked very suspicious. The next day, while talking with Huxley, Spartan realizes Phoenix technology adaptation ability in 2032, as he is now 3 times stronger than when he was in prison. Spartan becomes suspicious and suggests reviewing Phoenix's rehabilitation program when he is frozen. As expected, it was Dr. Cactu who installed the terrorist rehabilitation program in Phoenix. Spartan angrily goes to confront Cactu, but he receives only humiliation and is forced back to the frozen prison. He decides to go down to the sewer to arrest Phoenix. Huxley believes in Spartan, together against Cactus' orders, and captures Phoenix. Under the stinking sewer, there are many residents here. Not letting them wait for a long time, Friendly, the leader of the sewers, has his subordinates arrest three policemen and points the gun towards them. However, when Spartan talks to Friendly, he discovers that he and Friendly are actually on the same page against the idea of a fake happiness or lifestyle created by Cactu. Spartan gives Friendly bad news that Cactu is planning to use Phoenix to kill him. At this moment, Phoenix and his subordinates also appear. They immediately go down to the cellar and open fire on Spartan and Friendly. Being attacked by surprise, Spartan and Friendly's team are trapped in a rain of bullets. Friendly, on the other hand, is also not a paper tiger. He quickly counterattacks and shoots down the bridge, causing Phoenix to fall. Spartan also immediately joins the fight with a gun aiming at Phoenix. Phoenix quickly escapes from the sewer, runs to the upper ground, and flees away with a police car. Spartan and Huxley drive straight from the sewer to the ground chasing Phoenix, Spartan repeatedly shooting at Phoenix to slow down his car. Putting the driving task back to Huxley, Spartan climbs onto the roof and jumps over Phoenix's car. Phoenix fires at Spartan with the aim of turning his stomach into a mess, but Spartan unsuccessfully breaks the car door to grapple with Phoenix. After a while of fighting, Phoenix is thrown out of the car, rolling on the road. Spartan's situation was not much better. He could not stop the car on the road, so it crashes into a building and then stops. At this time, the sheriff and subordinates appear to arrest Spartan, while Friendly's army also accompanies Spartan to find Phoenix and Cactu. Spartan and Huxley go against the sheriff's orders and use a car to go to Cactu's office. While having a talk with Phoenix, Cactu thought he had successfully destroyed the Friendly army, so he is happily planning to upgrade his ideal society. Cactu doesn't expect that Phoenix has ordered his men to shoot and mercilessly throw his body into the fireplace. Spartan and Huxley also head to Cactu's office, but Phoenix already left long ago and is now on the way to the frozen prison to free more than 80 prisoners being held here. Worrying that Huxley would be in danger, Spartan has no choice but to make her faint with an electric shock and runs off to fight alone. By the time Spartan arrives at the prison, the policemen here were all killed, and the defrosting process of the prisoners is only 10 minutes away from completion. Spartan holds two guns up and fires non-stop at Phoenix. The criminal pretends to escape to distract him while running an iron machine to grip and shoot at Spartan. Hanging by the machine's arm, Spartan is fortunate to break the iron frame with the gas released from the machine when being shot by Phoenix. Phoenix continues to use advanced weapons to attack Spartan. Spartan patiently waits for the weapon to run out of energy so he can fight back Phoenix. With overwhelming strength, Phoenix repeatedly attacks Spartan. Just when Phoenix is about to knock Spartan out, he suddenly counterattacks Phoenix. At the last minute, Phoenix tries to use an iron bar to kill Spartan, but he is faster, using a cryogenic chemical and placing it in water on the ground, freezing everything including Phoenix. When he is completely frozen, Spartan swings over and kicks Phoenix in the head, ending the cruel criminal's life. It is getting worse as the machines in the prison have broken down and are exploding. Spartan manages to run as fast as he can to escape from the raging fire. The police arrive when everything is over. As Cactu is dead, frozen prison explodes. People start to doubt the ideal society of the police and that they have been living in a fantasy for so long. Friendly's army is also here to see the collapse of a fraud empire. Huxley is awake and comes to Spartan. While people are busy cleaning the battlefield, Spartan hugs and gives Huxley a very passionate kiss. This time, Huxley smiles happily and doesn't even consider this to be criminal anymore. Subscribe to watch more videos like this and don't forget to turn on your notification. That really helps my channel. Thanks for watching.